Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Subrata Sarkar. I'm a mechanical engineer working in manufacturing industry since last 22 years. Today I'm going to share a different topic which will be very much interesting for you. And you know, we all are using that, but we don't know about that. So I'll share some of my experience with you, and you'll find it is very interesting, and you know, and hopefully sometimes this information will be useful for you. That is a wristwatch. We all know the wristwatch. We all are using the wristwatch. But do you know what is actually inside the wristwatch, and most importantly, like how these are manufactured, and what is the technology of the wristwatch? Today I'm going to share this technical information, and I'm sure you'll like it. You can see this is the design of a wristwatch. This is a Rolex wristwatch design. This is a 3D model explored view. You can see the components of the wristwatch. There are a lot of hundreds of components inside this small wristwatch. And obviously, you know, this every component has got a different name. Even we don't know other than, you know, two or three components. Now, I'm not making the subject bold. I'll come in a very simple way. You know, number one, like for example, in a car, you know, this Mercedes, BMW, you know, Rolls Royce, they are the luxury world leader car manufacturer. In the same way, for the wristwatch, Rolex is the number one. There are other companies like, you know, this Omega, Angus, Swatch, you know, Tissot. And most of the manufacturer of the branded wristwatch, you know, luxury branded, as I can say, from Switzerland actually. And this is the dream watch actually. For me, this is a dream watch. The cost of this wristwatch is, you know, about more than 4 lakhs. So what is there inside is a small wristwatch having, you know, these sizes, maybe by weight, 20 grams, 30 grams, 50 grams, and cost is 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs. So what is there inside? So that was very interesting. You can see this is the actual, when you remove the back cover of the Rolex wristwatch, it will look like that. So there are hundreds of components. But the most important, the cost is because the components, the metals are very special. They have got a huge properties. Maybe in 50 years, 100 years, you don't need to do any maintenance or repair of this type of wristwatch actually. And today I'm discussing this topic because, you know, years back, I used to work in Germany in a company called Wutzenmann GmbH in South Germany. And at the time, I have got the opportunity to visit some of the, you know, wristwatch manufacturing company. And not some, the world number one wristwatch manufacturing company, that is a Rolex in Switzerland. And they have a you know, good relationship with our, you know, this the company where I was working in Wutzenmann. And so I've got the opportunity to visit their manufacturing setup and got a lot of different experience. And today I'm going to share this experience, special, you know, light and precision engineering, manufacturing, how they're doing. So this is the actual inside of the assembly shop of the Rolex wristwatch factory in Switzerland. And this is a component manufacturing section actually. They have got small machine, tabletop small machine, metal manufacturing, CNC machines. So they are making very small components. Even the components are so small you can hold by the hands. So this is a very precision engineering exercise. The Omega factory also have visited. It's a very similar actually infrastructure wise. You can see how jobs are doing machining. Machining means like from a solid metal, there is an equipment called metal cutting machines which removes the metal to get the final geometry of the components. So these are the process actually how these wristwatch components are manufactured. And for luxury brand of the watch, you know, the most of the dials and body of the watch, these are manufactured, you know, there's a different, every individual watch has a different design, so you have to do a lot of special program to get the geometry. So that's why these are so costly. You can say these are designer watch actually. It's not produced in a mass quantity, mass production is mostly in a batch production quantity. The cost of this high, you know, high and wristwatch are there. And you can see here in such a big picture, but the components are very small. Even if you cannot hold it properly with your hands, so and even you cannot see properly with your open eyes, so you have to, the operators and the, you know, worker, they need to put, you know, the special microscope on their eyes when they're doing this work. So it is very special. even after doing this machining in between, there are a lot of inspection and checking processes there as usual. And so in this way, the manufacture the different components, make the components ready, and after doing the check, they measure the components. Actually, the metals are very costly. They have got the different tremendous properties and strength at the same times. And so after that, it comes to the assembly line actually. And in watch assembly, you know, there's a one person don't do a single watch assembly, then complete doing other. They have a disc type of something where maybe 10 watch are, you know, arranged for doing this wristwatch assembly. And the ones and all the small components of the watch are kept in a, you can see this tray actually. So 10 watches are normally assembled together, and they are doing the assembly. And this is when the assembly is complete, you can see this picture just before putting the back cover of the wristwatch. So it looks like that in most of the cases, mechanical wristwatch. And when this dial is complete actually, so this is the view of the assembly fixture. And after doing that, they send it to the quality assurance department, and depending on the production types and the quality assurance sampling plan, they check these things and do the testings and all these things, and then finally it is ready for the market, and we are using today this wristwatch. Thank you very much. If you find this presentation is very much informative and interesting, and it's a new actual area you normally don't get into, normal engineering manufacturing sector, so you can share this video with your friends. You can subscribe my YouTube channel so that you can get this upcoming presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.